Stanford University researchers have discovered a rapid and sustainable way to synthetically produce a promising cancer-fighting compound right in the lab. The compound's availability has been limited because its only currently known natural source is a single plant species that grows solely in a small rainforest region of northeastern Australia. The compound designated EBC-46 and technically called Tigilanol Tiglate works by promoting a localized immune response against tumors. The response breaks apart the tumor's blood vessels and ultimately kills its cancerous cells. EBC-46 recently entered into human clinical trials following its extremely high success rate in treating a kind of cancer in dogs. Given its complex structure, however, EBC-46 had appeared synthetically inaccessible, meaning no plausible path seemed to exist for producing it practically in a laboratory. However, thanks to a clever process, the Stanford researchers demonstrated for the first time how to chemically transform an abundant plant-based starting material into EBC-46. As a bonus, this process can produce EBC-46 analogs, compounds that are chemically similar, but which could prove even more effective and potentially treat a surprisingly wide range of other serious maladies. These diseases, which include AIDS, multiple sclerosis, and Alzheimer's disease, all share biological pathways impacted by EBC-46 target, a key enzyme called protein kinase C, or PKC. The researchers reported their study in the journal Nature Chemistry. Tigilanol Tiglate initially turned up through an automated drug candidate screening process by Q Biotics, an Australian company. In Nature, the compound appears in the seeds of the pink fruit of the brushwood tree, Fontanea picrosperma. Moss whales, such as musky rat kangaroos that eat brushwood fruit, avoid the Tigilanol Tiglate rich seeds, which, when ingested, trigger vomiting and diarrhea. Injecting far smaller doses of EBC-46 directly into some solid tumors modifies the cellular signaling by PKC. Specifically, EBC-46 is proposed to activate certain forms of PKC, which in turn influence the activity of various proteins in the cancerous cells, attracting an immune response by the host's body. The resulting inflammation makes the tumor's vasculature or blood vessels leaky, and this hemorrhaging causes the tumorous growth to die. In the case of external cutaneous melanogenesis, the tumors scab up and fall off, and ways of delivering EBC-46 to internal tumors are being investigated. In 2020, both the European Medicines Agency and the Food and Drug Administration in the United States approved an EBC-46-based medication sold under the brand name Stelfont to treat mast cell cancer, the most common skin tumors in dogs. A study showed a 75% cure rate after a single injection and an 88% rate following a second dose. Clinical trials have since commenced for skin, head and neck and soft tissue cancers in humans. Based on these emerging research and clinical needs, coupled with SOSEED's geographical limitations, scientists have considered setting up special plantations for brushwood trees. But doing so presents a host of issues. For starters, the trees require pollination, meaning the right sort of pollinating animals must be on hand, plus trees must be planted in appropriate densities and distances to aid pollination. Furthermore, seasonal and climate variations affect the trees, along with pathogens. Setting aside plots for brushwood trees further poses land use problems. The researcher says that for sustainable, reliable production of EBC-46 in the quantities we need, we really need to go the synthetic route. A good starting point for making EBC-46 is the plant-derived compound 4-bol. More than 7,000 plant species produce 4-bol derivatives worldwide, and 4-bol rich seeds are commercially inexpensive. The researchers selected Croton tiglium, commonly known as purging croton, and herb used in traditional Chinese medicine. The first step in preparing EBC-46 is to grind up the seeds and run some hot solvent through them to extract the active ingredient, a pobal-rich oil. After processing the oil to yield pobal, the researchers then had to figure out how to overcome the previously insurmountable challenge of bidecking a part of the molecule called the bearing with carefully placed oxygen atoms. This is required to enable EBC-46 to interact with PKC and modify the enzyme's activity in cells. To guide their chemical and biological studies, the researchers relied on instrumentation at the Stanford Neuroscience Microscopy Service, the Stanford Cancer Institute Proteomics, Mass Spectrometry Shad Resource, and the Stanford Sherlock Cluster for Computer Modeling. With this guidance, the team succeeded in adding extra oxygen atoms in Fobel's bearing, first via a so-called Yin reaction conducted under flow conditions, where reactants mix as they run together through tubing. The team then introduced other bearing groups in a stepwise controlled manner to obtain the desired spatial arrangements of the atoms. In total, only 4 to 6 steps were required to obtain analogs of EBC-46 and a dozen steps to reach EBC-46 itself. The researcher hopes that the far broader availability of EBC-46 and its PKC-influencing cousin compounds afforded by this breakthrough approach will accelerate research into potentially revolutionary new treatments.